strategic management meeting to be held by the Nigerian police this year. Since our last meeting, some new trends and patterns of crime have emerged, and this makes it imperative for us to collectively re-evaluate our strategies with a view to sustaining our dominance of the public space from criminal elements. In this regard, this meeting is convened to achieve three major objectives. Firstly, is to review the current internal security situation of the country, evaluate emerging trends, and evolve strategies to curtail them. Secondly, we shall be undertaking a detailed assessment of the implementation of community policing strategy as approved by the federal government. Thirdly, we shall also assess the progress so far made in our overall internal security activities. The recent incidents of armed robbery, kidnapping, banditry, most especially in Kaduna, Niger, Kogi, Katsina, and Zamfara states, have prompted the need for full and speedy rollout of community policing strategy across the country. Let me acknowledge the hard work of the commissioners of police in both states for all their efforts in curtailing crime in those states. Accordingly, as conceptualized, formulated, and approved by the federal government, the current effort will be citizen-driven and driven by members of each community. I'm talking of community policing strategy. The plan will involve the setting up of community policing committees at ward, local government, and state levels, including the federal capital territory. The committees, when inaugurated, are to identify credible and suitable citizens from across each locality for appointment as special constables who will serve as community policing officers. The committees are also expected to identify the security challenges peculiar to their communities and partner with the local police in formulating plans that will mitigate the challenges. The community policing officers are to deal with and resolve low-level security issues without necessarily resorting to police stations, unless the issue is of serious legal and security consequences and require police intervention. The idea is to improve the capacity of the communities to develop solutions to local security problems and working closely with their local police. It is our projection that when fully operational, the citizens will be in control of their security with the guidance of the police and the community policing committees, while the Nigeria police will then concentrate on the management of violent and other highly organized crimes with a view to proactively responding to them in the manner that engender public confidence, trust, and public satisfaction in police service delivery. Faced with increasingly sophisticated and enterprising criminal threats, our community policing approach recognizes that the police alone, as a law enforcement agency, does not have the exclusive capacity to solely manage the security threats. Thus, a multi-agency and citizen-driven approach remains the most potent strategy to deal with the current trend in crime. The success of the community policing initiative in Nigeria, like in other policing claims, depends largely on the extent to which strategic police managers, particularly state commissioners of police, area commanders, and divisional police officers, understand its concepts and practice. This conference shall therefore dwell extensively on exposing senior police officers to the concept and implementation plan of the community policing strategy. In the course of the meeting, therefore, the specific roles of police managers at various command levels and other strategic actors in the implementation process shall also be clearly delineated. The senior police officers here seated shall also be adequately briefed on the modalities for the vetting and certification of personalities that will be members of the community policing committees. This is with a view to ensuring that only credible and suitable persons are appointed into the committees. At no time had our nations required our dedication, commitment, resilience, and professionalism than now. Consequently, I charge you all to continue to provide courageous and knowledge-driven leadership that is required to advance the attainment of our internal security mandate. I wish to ensure the citizens that with their cooperation and the blessing of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we shall continue to initiate strategies and undertake coordinated operations that are directed at taking the battle to the doorsteps of the criminal elements. This has been our strategic approach, and it has been effective in disseminating the bandits, kidnappers, and other violent criminals who have been taking advantage of the natural topography of our nation to threaten our security. I also wish to appeal to all citizens, and particularly the state governors, to continue to support and partner with us as we implement the community policing strategy across the country. It is only when we present a common front that we can, as a people, defeat our common enemy, who are the bandits, kidnappers, and arm robbers, who are testing our will and attempting to alter our values for peace and security. I thank you all for your attention, and I look forward to professionally rewarding engagement. Thank you.